Welcome everybody, you're watching Mr. Fugu Data Science. I decided to create a shorter version of my original video of sending data from Python to Postgres, which was 42 minutes. This video is the bare bones sending a CSV file and a data frame, making our connection and running a few basic queries as a proof of concept. If you do not have psycopg2, you need to install it. In this file, I have the Windows and Mac installs if you have problems with this, which would be on my GitHub. I'd like to say thank you to my recent subscribers and viewers lately. This imports psycopg2, also psycopg2 extras, pandas for the data frame manipulation as usual. And for me, I have user credentials that I need to import with the function of config, which will be storing my key value pairs. If you do not need or do not have user credentials and just want to use this for illustrative purposes and practice, feel free to try this setup and see if that works for you. So I need to call in my parameters, which are my key value pairs stored in that file under that function name of config, and create this connection where I'm calling in psycopg2 and I'm placing in it my user credentials, which are key value pairs. And we need to create this cursor. And the cursor is allowing us to send and retrieve data as well as run queries. And lastly, I'm using something called autocommit equals true. And this is going to allow me to immediately run something after I execute it. Sometimes this isn't needed or unwanted. The data that we're using today will be some fake generated data that I made a while back where we have a credit card email, first and last name, and a primary phone number. So we have, let's figure out how many entries we have. So we have a little over 5,800 entries. That's going to be important later, so we could keep track of how many things we send off into Postgres. Let's create our function. And this function is going to create a staging table for us where we're going to basically set up our schema. So you're going to use some that cursor, but we're going to execute that cursor and we're going to set up, drop the table if it exists. And I'm going to call this staging fake people. And for me, I'm going to show you something. This cascade is useful if you have dependencies from using your data prior, such as setting up like triggers and things like this, you know, or some kind of indexes. Something that's going to create your dependency. And then after we drop this, if it was already existing, I'm going to create an unlogged table and just call in your staging fake people. And now we're going to call in the column names we want to create. So I want a credit card, an email, first name and last name, and my primary phone number. So these are all going to be text. So let's just cut and paste all those. Now, just for cleanliness, let's just space this out a little bit. Okay, so that's looking pretty good. What else do we need to do? We need to send this off. But how do we send it off? This do something that looks similar to if you were reading in a file that you have, where you're basically like, think of it as iterating through your file, and we're sending off the schema for this table that we just created. And now I'm interested in sending off this CSV file to Postgres. So how's that going to work? Well, this create function called send CSV to Postgres. And I'm going to need a connection, the CSV file, as well as the table of interest that I would like to send this to. And I'm going to create a SQL statement, which is going to use similar notation of how you would actually send this file off if you're doing this from the command line. So you're going to call in the standard in, where you're saying copy the string from the standard in and with the CSV header and some delimiter, which will be your comma separated values. Okay, so we need to call in our file and we're going to use open, call that CSV and use it under the read pretense. And you don't need to do this, but I'm doing it just for aliasing purposes. So let's use that with open connection once again and take our cursor. And what are we going to do with this cursor? We're going to alias this and think of this as like looking through a file once again. And we're going to use something less interesting where I'm saying truncate. The truncate is very useful because you want to think of this as not allowing you to accept duplicates. So let's make a note and say avoid duplicates here. And we need to take that cursor and do what's called a copy expert, where we're going to take in our SQL right here, our SQL statement, allowing us to send off these data. And then you need that trusty old percent sign. And then we're going to call in the file that we're trying to send. And then you need to take that connection and commit so we can send that off. So hopefully this will work. Let's find out. So we need to, since I just forgot two things. You should always consider closing the cursor and closing the connection so you can free up resources. I'm not going to do it here because I'm lazy and I don't want to just keep scrolling up and rerunning to execute this each time to make the connection. But as a node, you should do this as good practice. So now let's call in the connection, the file that I want to take, and where am I sending this to, which would be my fake people staging table. I forgot something. This space right here is really important and threw me off. I couldn't figure out why I was getting an error. All right. Now, after we have fun sending that off, let's zoom out just a little bit. Let's send some basic queries so we can make sure that this is cooperating. And let's just count everything. And remember I said that we should look into how many rows we actually have. This is at the point where we're going to see why. So you need to call the cursor.execute, throw in your query, and then to actually print off what you're doing, you can either fetch one, fetch many, or fetch all. I'm going to fetch all. It's only going to return one thing. So there we are. We're correct on how many items we actually had. So we could change this up a little bit for being lazy and for brevity. And you say, oh, wow, okay, I printed everything off. That's fine. What could we do with this? Let's call this in as a data frame real quick, see if this will read in. Okay, but you don't have your column names. Okay, that's fine. We got it working. We just don't have the column names. We could figure that out if we needed that. Let's move on to an alternate way that we can deal with this, where we can call in pandas.io.sql. Just alias it as some name. Set up the query that you're wanting to run. Inside of the SQL IO, you can say, read this query where I'm taking my query and my connection from psycopg, printing that off. So it takes in all of my data. And if you notice, I have my column names here that I didn't have to worry about manipulating. If you had a connection set up differently, you can call it in this way and do some string formatting to call it in. We can take our data frame, convert it to a dictionary list, and send that off as well. This is one way that we can deal with this. Let's create a new table to store everything. So what I do is a lazy way is I cut and paste this. I'm going to just call this two. We really don't need this because I'm not in a position where I have these data stored with anything else like indexes or any kind of triggers or anything like that. So we can set it up like this for our second table. Cut and paste our second little cursor that we're going. Let's do this so we can distinguish these tables. Set those up. Create a function that's going to allow us to start dealing with these data. So let's consider that if the length of this is greater than zero, meaning that basically I have some kind of data frame, I'm taking in these columns of the data frame. And what am I going to do with this? I would like to take in the columns where I'm going to separate by a comma, and I'm going to do a string join of the data frame column names. But then what else do I need to do with this? I would like to take the values and put in whatever I'm going to use from the string formatting. This will be used for our query with inside of Postgres, where now we're going to do another string join of what? Let's do a list comprehension, and everything will be a string inside of this. So let's use the double quotations. And we're going to iterate inside of this. We're going to take our column names. This will go here. And we need to do this insert statement. So I'm going to just call this insert statement. And it'll be abbreviated. So this insert into this table, what? We got a couple things we need to insert into this. So let's figure out what this is going to insert. The table, the actual column names, and the values that we want to take in. And the column names are going to get put into basically one string of all the column names just separated by columns. So that's what was going on with that. We need to call in our cursor to execute our query. And we're going to use our trusty old truncate with the space. And we're going to join these strings. So let's take in our table, and let's take in the fact that we need to end the query. Let's make sure that we remember we're avoiding duplicate values. Create that cursor, so take in that connection, and then this is where we use our psycopg2.extras execute batch, and you're going to take in your cursor, your insert statement, and you're going to call the data frame values. All right, so you're converting that data frame and taking just the values since we already created the names. Okay, is this looking good? Seems like it's looking appropriate. So then we need to call our little function that we just created, and we need to call in the data frame, take in the table that we're going to send our fake little data, and this is the second one that we created, and the cursor. And we get an error because I neglected one thing. One more thing, insert into the table. Oops. There we go. Let's run a quick query and make sure that this fun thing actually worked. What a delight. Let's select everything from this. Staging fake people too. And let's limit this. There we go. So we got this to work. Perfect. Another way that you can look into doing this, if you didn't want to do this formatting, you can just look at converting it into a CSV file, I suppose, and send it off that way. But I would like to say thank you for watching this video. Please like, share, and subscribe. And if you subscribe, turn on that notification bell. As always, I hope this brought utility to someone. Thank you for watching. Bye.